Welcome everyone to a new feature that we're calling the Saigon Report. During this video series, we're going to discuss in detail, demonstrate, and fire weapons that were used during the Vietnam era. Today, we're going to talk about the standard issue sidearm during the Vietnam War, and that would be the M1911 A1 pistol. What is significant about the M1911 A1 pistol? Well, if you didn't know, this was the first semi-automatic magazine-fed firearm handgun to be adopted by the U.S. Army. Now, before this, it was all revolvers. Specifically, the firearm that this replaced was the 1892 Navy Army revolver in 38 Colt. Now, you should know, if you don't, that the M1911 A1 was chambered in the 45 ACP, which stands for Automatic Colt Pistol. What was significant about this? Well, number one, up to this point, all the Army sidearms either held 5 or 6 rounds. This one held 7 in the magazine, plus 1 in the chamber. Single column magazine. Yes, the original 1911 magazines only held 7. You guys are like, yeah, but my 1911 holds 8. I got that, because they redesigned the followers. But the originals held 7 rounds of 230 grain ball ammunition, right there. Now, what you may not know is when John Browning designed this gun, he designed it so that it could be taken apart, field stripped by the average private PFC in the field using only the bottom of their magazine. If you didn't know, you could take the bottom base pad of this magazine and push it right there and it fits perfectly. That's something that Browning did very deliberately. If you're going to issue a firearm to soldiers, to troops, to the Navy, to the Marines, whatever, you want to make sure that they don't need a tool to disassemble it in the field to clean it. Now, obviously, there are armorers who are going to detail strip them and take them apart and so forth, but for average in-the-field maintenance, right, just G.I. Joe, and he's out in the desert, he's in the woods, he's in the jungle, he needs to take it apart and clean it, oil it, lube it, you don't want that guy to have a tool, a special tool. Because what have we learned over the years? We've learned that G.I. Joe will lose the tool. If you make a specific tool for that gun, when he needs it, it won't be there. Trust me, I know. So what else is unique and special about this gun? Well, it has, if you guys didn't know, a manual safety on this side right here. You got a manual thumb safety. You have a grip safety right there. And it is a single action pistol. Unlike most of your modern firearms, this one was single action. And how you were taught to carry it, at least when I was a United States Marine, I was taught to carry it chamber empty, magazine inserted, loaded in the holster. Now you say, why would you want to do that? Because safety, because safety. Now, if you were going to be in an area where you knew you were going to encounter the enemy, obviously you would load it up completely, pull the hammer back, put the manual safety on, and carry it like that. Let's talk about how you would carry your gun. If you look on my side right here, you will see an all-leather black flap holster. Now, in World War II, the leather was brown. The one main change between World War II, Korea, and Vietnam was all the brown leather was transitioned over to black leather. Essentially, the holsters were the same. They went from brown to black, and they've got the ubiquitous US on them. Flap holsters with a tie down. How many people tied them down to their legs? I'm guessing not many. Who would carry this? Well, obviously officers and NCOs would carry this. A handgun was not normally standard issue for troops in the field, PFCs, privates, and so forth. If you were on a vehicle crew, you would be issued a handgun. If you were on a crew-served weapon crew, for instance, you carried the M60 machine gun, you were a mortarman or so forth, you would be issued one of these. But the average grunt, the average rifleman, would not carry a pistol. Something else that the 1911 pistol was very famous for was used by the tunnel rats. And a tunnel rat wasn't a specific MOS. You didn't join the Army or the Marine Corps and they said, okay, from this point forward, you're gonna be a tunnel rat. If you were a small, slight of frame person, you ended up being a tunnel rat. If you were 6'2", 230 pounds, you probably weren't going down into a tunnel. But if you were 5'8" or 5'7", only weighed about 155, guess what? You were going down into the tunnel. And what would you use? You would use a 1911 A1 pistol and your standard G.I. Joe green angle head flashlight. Now this one's got a red lens on it. You take the red lens off and you can make it a white lens. And you say, but Paul, those angle head flashlights are made of plastic. They're probably pretty flimsy, right? Well, let me tell you a little story. I can tell you for a fact that the angle head flashlight with 2D batteries in it weighs about a pound or so and will split a man's skull. Take that to the bank. I've seen it happen. I know that it can happen. And you can split a man's skull and still turn the light on and use it. The tunnel rats, no surefires back then, no super cool LED bulbs, an incandescent bulb, angle head flashlight, and your 1911. That's what you had to go down into the tunnels. And they did it all the time, every day. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1911 A1, the first semi-automatic magazine-fed handgun issued to the U.S. Army, Marine Corps, Navy, Air Force, and used in Vietnam.